we have never heard the dynamics of this. Okay, now we look little bit into the history of the satellite. The first satellite launched was Sputnik. And it was launched in 1957, and the month was October for us, and it was a Russian satellite. So once this satellite was launched, it was not known to USA, and the Cold War was going on. So once America came to know about this, so immediately this space race started, and immediately America then launched its Explorer satellite. So in those days, a lot of money were invested, and its weight was 200 pounds. Explorer was just 20 pounds. And launched in 1958. Time I don't remember exactly, but it may be January, February. And this was American satellite. So in the Explorer, what happened? Explorer was just a cylindrical body looking like this. And there were four constile antenna attached to this. These were meant for communication purpose. And this satellite was said to rotate about this axis, which is the minor axis. But within few days, this satellite started tumbling. Tumbling means it started rotating about a different axis, and finally it settled about this axis. The rotation changed, and if we go through the attitude dynamics, so there we can learn that the angular momentum is conserved, a system which is free from the external forces. External torque, so angular momentum will be conserved, but not the energy. So this transfile, these were flexible antenna, and energy has started dissipating. So you know that kinetic energy can be written as 1 by 2 I times omega square. So this was the kinetic energy, and the angular momentum can be written as I times omega. Or in the scalar notation, we can simply write H equal to I omega. And if you write this as T, so you can write in terms of T omega equal to, or simply we can replace I omega. So this we can write as 2T divided by omega. We replace omega completely. So omega equal to 2t divided by I equal to omega square. And once we insert here in this place, so I omega 2t divided by I under root, this is it. So as you can see that the left hand side, is it visible? And are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Okay. So here what we have written, that h equal to I times 2t divided by I under root. So this quantity is a constant. Angular momentum does not change. But this quantity t is not a constant. And why? Because of this transtile antenna, this has started vibrating. Because once it was launched in the orbit, so vibration was setting. And because of that vibration and the elasticity of this antenna, it has started dissipating in this. So the total energy of the satellite, it has started dissipating. So this has started decreasing. So how this h can remain constant? This is a conserved quantity, which is free from the external moment or the torque. So this quantity cannot change. So if we write here by little changing it, so this I we can bring it inside and this I we can bring it. Immediately then you can see that as the t decreases, to keep h constant I must increase. So here it was rotating about the minor axis. So the finally the satellite it started rotating about the major axis. So it changed its orientation, and that was the first learning in space, that the satellite must be set to rotate about the major axis, not about the minor axis, if you are looking for its stability. Just 1 minute, one phone is coming. Hello? कल 4 बजे हो जाएगा, तो 5 बजे से मीटिंग से मिली तो सुबह में है। हाँ ठीक है। So this was the first learning in the space, and that came with this explorer. And thereafter, the massive research started in satellite attitude dynamics also. Before that, there was not any research in this area. Only thing that celestial mechanics was, the orbital mechanics was investigated a lot. It started from the time of Gauss. And then a lot of research were done in the orbital mechanics, but this area was not touched much. Newton did some of the work, but it was not so much that going into the physics of the system, looking into its behavior and other things. So Indian mission has started in 1975. The first was Aryabhatta. And it was launched in 1975 from Russia. These are fabricated by ISRO, but the launching station was Cosmodrome in Russia. In 1979, this is June 7, Bhaskar 1 was launched. This was also launched from Russia. hypostenuse. India then thereafter started building its own launch vehicle. So the launch vehicle SLV-1, SLV-2 and 3, they were the experimental ones. But the first SLV launched, it was a four-stage rocket. With Rhone satellite payload. Launched on August 10, 1979, but failed. And because many of its previous ones, they were failing one by one. So therefore, SLV means satellite launch vehicle. S for satellite, L for launch, V means vehicle. But because of its continuous failure, this was also in the paper in those days, it used to be like the sea-loving vehicle, SLV. But later on, the things were improved, and SLV-3, another launch, it was the second experimental launch. July 1898. And Rohini satellite, another one, was successfully placed in the orbit. So placing the satellite in the orbit, here whatever you are looking, these are all low orbit, not in the geostationary orbit. Generally, once the satellite is inducted into the orbit, say this is the Earth, and from any ground station you are launching the satellite into the orbit. So here, this is the launch point, where if the satellite is inducted into the orbit, this is V. So depending on the velocity direction, this satellite will be either moving in the velocity direction and magnitude, it will be moving in a circular orbit or elliptical orbit or hyperbolic orbit. So all the three are possible, but it depends on the magnitude and direction of the velocity vector. So once the satellite is injected into the orbit, you will see that its trajectory is shown like this. So on the big earth will be shown like this, and then the rocket trajectory may be shown like this. So here the satellite is getting injected into the orbit. And this altitude from the surface of Earth, it will be around 250 kilometers. And thereafter, you are looking for whatever the orbit you are looking for. So from here, this orbit is corrected. And that we call as the trajectory transfer. So orbit is corrected, and then corrected means the orbit will be raised. So if the orbit is 250 kilometers, so in few weeks, the satellite orbit will decay and it will hit the Earth because of atmospheric drag. Though the atmosphere is very feeble there, it's a very rare spot, but still it's there. And so the impact of those atmospheric molecules, the satellite experiences drag, and therefore the energy dissipates. So satellite energy, it can be written as E equal to minus mu by 2, for say E prime, where mu is G times M and A is semi-major axis. So you can see that E prime, this is called the specific energy of the satellite. So this is the total energy, kinetic energy plus potential energy, and it's a negative. If it is zero, that means A becomes infinity. And this is for parabolic orbit. Okay, if E prime becomes positive, that becomes a hyperbolic orbit. And then obviously in that case the satellite will leave the Earth's atmosphere and it will escape into the space. So the for practical purpose, what is desirable that the orbit should be elliptical or either circular. So to escape the drag, you can see from this place, if the drag is there, then the left-hand side will dissipate. It will decrease in magnitude. Let me go to another page. Not in that way. The E dissipates. E prime equal to minus mu by 2. So this becomes smaller. So this is already negative. Say it's elliptical orbit. So this will become further negative. That means if it is minus 5, it will become minus 25 later on. So magnitude wise it's increasing, but as a whole the sign wise it's a decreasing. So this energy starts dissipating. And we will explore all these things through mathematics later on. The classes. Class
chapter. Okay.
So energy once starts dissipating, the left hand side say initially it was minus 5, so mu is a constant which is nothing but g times m, g is the universal gravitational constant and m is the planetary mass, and divided by 2 times a. So this is minus 5, later on it becomes minus 25. So what happens to this? That means the a is shrinking, a shrinks. The semi-major axis, it shrinks. And A shrinking means the orbit is becoming smaller and smaller. So this is your Earth and this is the satellite nearby, 250 kilometers orbit. And if you do not raise it, so what happens? This starts decaying. So the orbit will continuously decay. As the energy goes down, it will decay, and it will enter into the dense atmosphere where it will start burning. And then it will be reduced to dust. Okay, and therefore the satellite has to be raised once it's launched in the orbit. So generally your all the remote sensing satellites, it may be from 700 kilometers to 1000 kilometer orbit, altitude, which is measured from the surface of the Earth. And remote sensing satellite, they are launched in the sun synchronous orbit. Sun synchronous orbit for 700 kilometers, it will fall around, orbit inclination will be 97.8 degrees. And it looks like this. So we'll discuss about and this is retrograde orbit. So while we are discussing in this context, I would like to mention here that I lie between 0 to 90 degrees, less than 90 degrees, this is called the prograde orbit. The sense of rotation of the satellite strength of our vital rotation. Is the same as the rotation of earth. And if I is greater than 90 degrees, this is called retrograde orbit. And the sense of rotation here is opposite to the Earth. This is opposite to the Earth rotation. So Earth rotates on its axis from west to east. So this is the, if you look from the top, so this is anti-clockwise motion. So looking from the top, it becomes an anti-clockwise motion. So if your orbit is, satellite is orbiting like this, in this sense, around the Earth, so this is prograde orbit, while once it is, the inclination, if it keeps changing, so this direction will change. And instead of satellite, keep the rotation same, the way the satellite is moving in this orbit, this inclination will take less than 90 degrees, this is. Okay, with the equator, let us say for the time being, with respect to the equator, this orbit is, I is less than 90 degrees. As you increase the inclination, it will reach 90 degrees and thereafter it will exceed that. And rotation since remaining same, so here it becomes in the opposite direction. You can see that this orbit will look like this and this orbit is looking like this. So this has the same sense of rotation as the rotation of the Earth, while this has opposite sense of rotation. Therefore, this is called the retrograde orbit, while this is called the prograde orbit. And if I equal to 90 degree exactly, so this becomes polar orbit. And I equal to 0, this is equatorial orbit. So do you have any question till now?
No, sir.
The space vehicle we can divide it into according to its functionality in the various categories. One is a space carrier vehicle. Columbia. Columbia, and then the Challenger, etc. So this takes from Earth to the space and it's a reusable vehicle basically. unmanned Earth satellite. This can be divided according to the functionality as the scientific satellite. So for atmospheric study, biological process, oceanography, measuring the depth of the ocean, studying the behavior of the ocean, all those things. And they fall into the remote sensing satellite. Altitude will be 100 to 1000 kilometers, but as you know, 100 is the limit for the space as we have defined earlier. But what happens that if it is of low altitude, that is surely once it's been launched, so people know that this is being used for what purpose. It may be using, they may be using for ocean navigation. Oceanography, where they are measuring the bottom of the ocean terrain, what we call as the topography, but it will not survive for more than a few days. Already the drag at 250 kilometers is enough to reduce it, the satellite to dust into 3 weeks. So you can consider that at this height what will happen. So the remote sensing satellite, generally it will be not be at the 300 kilometer altitude. And they are sun synchronous. Sun synchronous implies that they are always facing the sun. And that is done for the purpose that they always get the sunlight from the sun so that the onboard antenna, the solar cell, it keeps working, solar antenna. If the solar cell does not work, the satellite will stop working after some time once the battery exhausts. So mostly those satellites are sun synchronous satellites. And then we have the satellites which are launched at a higher altitude, which is injected into the orbit, geostationary orbit. So those are communication satellites. The scientific satellite, and then the space carrier vehicle we have already written. Then the application satellites for various the spying purpose military satellite, communication satellite. Remote sensing is also falls here in this place in the application satellite. Remote sensing. And meteorological studies, study of the atmosphere, all those things also get included in this. Then we have the manned satellite, which is the, currently the International Space Station falls in that category. And also some satellite can go, small satellite can go there, and that may be manned one. So that also falls in the manned satellite. But orbital support vehicle is another concept where the International Space Station it especially falls, because it's the main vehicle to which other many small vehicles will be attached. Like the to the International Space Station, this the Russian and the American satellites, they are attached from time to time. They go study and then return back. So on the next page, we can wind up now. So we have the manned Earth satellite. For this, high reliability is required. Orbital support vehicle in this category is in long life, big size, just like ISS, International Space Station, Salyut, Mir, the Skylab first from America. These are two Russian. This is also from America. But here, this is International Space Cooperation is there, and therefore this is called the International Space Station. So many countries are involved in that, Canada, America, then France, Russia. So we stop here with response to your attendance. Ivan Minna.